out today. We get to work on the 2012 F-150 Lariat sunroof. Plastic slides. That broke on it. Apparently that's a pretty common issue with these. After time, the little plastic parts get brittle and then break. Now I just gotta pull it all apart, pull the interior apart, and replace the slides and put it back together. A lot of time for little parts and $35 part. But if you take it to a shop, I think they're charging about 8 hours worth of labor, so it can get expensive. Hope y'all enjoy. Stay tuned to watch the whole thing. I'm going to try to cut out as much of the slow time as I can so that, hopefully it don't take no 8 hours. And my video should not take 8 hours. It should be short. We'll see what happens. All right. Y'all enjoy. Some of the videos I've been watching have been saying take out this passenger seat. So that's the first thing we're going to do before I try to get up in there and move the sunroof out of the glass out, and then trying to move the headliner. And I think it'll just be easier to go ahead and get this seat out. It'll give me a lot of working room. All right, here we go. Screws for the glass. That should just lift up out of there. Set it down real gentle. Now we get to start pulling all these, pull the visors down, trim panels down, and the headliner should come down. And once we got that, then we get to the real project of the track. Oh, shouldn't be too bad. I feel like we're moving pretty good right now. So, we'll keep going at it. Hangs there. Hangs there. Now this thing should start coming down. I say these got Velcro. Some of them have magnets. But man, it's ready to come down. Just kind of work your way around and let it loose from things. Looks like this plastic piece needs to come down with it. Just two screws. Does that fall and catch it? This one. That comes on down. I gotta figure out how it plugs from. It plugs from the rearview mirror there. Of course, I got camera in the way there. Slide him out of the way for now. Yeah, there's a, like a release. See, at least on the bottom, they pull out. All right, and just stuff that up there. All right, here we go. Okay, now we're in the very back driver's side. There's two plugs up there. Hold all this wiring together, goes all the way through, and we just gotta get up here. The release, pull it out. Release on that, pull it out. All right, now the headliner is pulled down. And now we see if we can get it out of the way. We can get to the real thing up there. pull that thing down and rebuild it. All right. Set that down there. Now, on the videos on the left, the guy just put the liner in there and we just let the sunroof down. I think that's what we'll end up doing. Okay. Well, there's a few. Looks like maybe, let's see, maybe 10 mil, 8 or 10 mil there, kind of around it. And then there's four on each side. I think they said 13 mil it takes to get it down. Put pull on that part. Drain tubes in all four corners. Pull those loose. What I've seen is the last piece right here. Under pull that over, tie it into one of your holes. The string over to the other side over here, tie it off to this handle. Loop in here. The string off to here. Now, let's see if we can let that down a little bit. Now that'll hold it. Really is best if you have a friend.
Take these two bolts off this little brace here. Just don't get in our way when we're shooting. Table. Okay, I'll take this motor out, pull it out, and then once we got the motor out, then we can work on pulling everything else up. So, here we go. This track off, flip it over. All right, here we go. Okay, now we got three rivets here on each side. Got to drill out, and then that piece will come off. And we can start exchanging out the hardless plates. Kind of separate that. There's the back. Down and back. And just pull it apart. The side. So you're going to take this piece off here as it goes across. And it uses Phillips screws. I really wish they wouldn't go back and forth between Phillips and T20s. Pull that out. That's inside. Screws over there. Now, let's push the side out. It's hitting something now. Okay, you can see sliding back until it hits that stop right there. All right, you take just a take something flat, knock that down, and then it'll slide out. We'll get that knocked out, and we'll continue on. All right, hold on. Let me put this wood behind this thing, maybe I'll make it a little sturdier so my hit is not bouncing. There we go. purple pieces there. Slide this thing over. There's some parts over here. Now we get to all the new parts. Slide them in there, grease it all up, and we'll be ready to put it back together. Taking about 3 hours so far. So yeah, I could see being close to 8 hours to do it. All right, here we go. Here's the new kit, and like I said, Amazon for $36, I believe. Next day shipping. Well, Amazon Prime. Next day shipping. It comes with your sides. Comes with your grease that you're going to need for the track. And they say use every bit of it. Move that track up real good. It comes with your rivets that you had to drill out. So that's all good. Now we have a slide assembly here. Just gotta remember how it all went together. I believe it will be marked right and left. I don't think this one does. Let's show you what I'm going through here. Okay, this side does the broken side, which was the right hand side. This is the good side. So, I just gotta find all the pieces. I'm a little disappointed this thing's not labeled right and left, but and there seems to be a little bit of a difference. I'll have to see if that's going to cause a problem. See, this is not on this piece. Everything else looks the same, but if I have to, I can zip that off. But it's just going to take some looking at to figure it all out. I finally figured it out. I think I got this bit on here. Supposed to be. Thank you. sure these little clips hang up. And finally got that sucker in there. Man, it was a challenge. And I'll grease up that track really good. But first off, I went ahead and stuck that in there. I shouldn't have let out. Now, I'll grease this sucker up real good. And go on in. You want to wear gloves doing all this. Ah, better kit that doesn't actually says right and left on things. Yeah, that's kind of annoying. So I think what I had was actually had them switched. Now we're on. Get everything where it's supposed to be now. Take it all and put it back together. I figure what's catching on there. Just need a little help. Has little square holes on it. They just fit into those square pieces there. Just slide it out in there. They don't even clip or anything. They just kind of sit in there. So sit them in there and then grab all the front of it and slide the front forward. Forward. And that'll do it. this little piece, since it can slide by itself. That's why I unclipped it, man. That made it a lot easier just handling things. Unclipping that. Yeah. Grease this thing up real good. Slide them in there, make sure those tabs don't catch on anything. Slide it up in there, catch it up with that piece. And let's see, just get it up here, line it up there, push down, click, and now it's all together. Take the rest of this grease, a little bit up in here, the channels, all up in here. As it moves back and forth, it'll grab a hold of that grease and move it where it needs to be. Alright. We're going to grease up this other side. I'm just going to use every bit of this grease. Get it all in here. Alright, we start assembling it back. Screws on this cross piece. That's connected across. Back through the hole here. Once that's started, go to the other side, get it started. Push it all the way up, and we'll flip it over and put the rivets in, and everything will start going back together. Real good. Real good. Load it in our gun. Make sure it's seated down good. Really? And then they eject it. Oh, man. Just got rivets there. Oh man, with arthritis, that rivet's getting a little tough. Yeah, I don't do these all the time. All right, now it's back together. Motor's in. Screws back in. Almost there. So it's tight. The next one. Just tight, but I don't want to break this plastic.
together. Been out here long enough. Awesome. Alright, we're back for lunch. I can't believe y'all never told me I had grease on my nose. Now just let me keep going. Now I'm gonna wash my hands. Looked in the mirror, saw the grease. Shame on y'all. Anyway, we're back. We're gonna put all these screws back in, get it cinched back up there, and keep moving forward. Get this thing done. All right. I need to remember to get that retainer clip fell down. Let's see if I can find it. Our torque screws and start putting this back together. Can't see what I'm doing, so. We're going back up with the headliner, and then we'll worry about that. Plug that motor in.
one more time and see how it does. Right back, it's sealed up. Let's see. Tilt. Tilt. Down. Seals up. Alright. Now, do the rest of the interior back. We're going to take it tonight. Tomorrow I'll come finish it up. Should be a pretty quick finish up. Not very far from having it done. I'm pretty excited. So stay tuned. You'll be right back and get her done. Alright. I think I've got a total of 5 hours into it so far. That's including record time trying to set up and everything. So, you know, you could probably get it done in 4 to 5 hours, maybe. So anyway, I'll stay tuned and we'll see what happens tomorrow. All right
okay, back out here the next day. The truck's running. I had to jump it off. So I left the key forward last night, all night long. Phone charging in here, jump pack charging in here, killed the battery. So, I had to go ahead and jump it off so I could lower the windows down and start working in here. We'll let it run for a little while and we'll get everything put back together. Going. I mean, it's just trim pieces going back on and seat back in. We're good. So, y'all enjoy. I'll be able to have to listen to the motor run a little while. Just let it run. Anyway, when you're working on this, if you gotta take a break, take the key out, take it with you. But you don't do that. Oh, man. Sat down, grabbed all the key, and I'm like, what in the world left that thing for? gotta do. Keep it going. Great truck. You gotta do. Just like it's supposed to. Closes. Back in raises up to where it's supposed to be. That was the problem I was having. Back in wasn't raising up where it was supposed to be and leaving it open. Slides just like it's supposed to. Slides in and out. Works perfect. Alright. Alright, now it's just cleaning everything up. So, hope y'all enjoyed. Hope y'all learned something. Hope y'all saw what not to do. Saw the headaches I went through by not removing this trim piece. Really wish I would have. I believe it would have went smoother. I'm very happy for $36 part, $35 part, something like that. I was able to fix it, and I don't have to worry about it leaking anymore. I can go wash this thing. It's pollen season, and you gotta wash cars all the time. So, I can drive through a car wash now and not be worried. I would next time, if, hopefully I don't have it next time. But hopefully, if I was to help somebody else do it on their vehicle, maybe that'd be next time. I would tell them to go ahead and loosen those screws off, push it up into place, tighten them down, unplug it up here so that you don't actually hit the button. And that way, it'll be sealed up until you can get the parts in and we can spend the time to go ahead and finish it off. But it's not a hard project. It's a time-consuming project. So don't be afraid to take it on. All right. Till next time.